What is going on, friends? We are back with the World Cup tiebreaker between Team Italy and Spain. This is the first game. There are three games. Whoever wins two games first moves on to the next round, which is semi-finals of World Cup. And Snow is playing for Team Italy. Poik is playing for Team Spain. Poik brought this Aurora Veil offense made by NGNP. Black Oblivion used this before. It's just Elite Greninja would have it. It's like T-Spikes, Spikes, Taunt. And then it had Gunkshot at first, but he might have changed it, we will see. And yeah, it's like SD Mobile, Wincoon, Aurora Veil, like screens, Ninetales with Hail, Hypnosis, Dragon Dance, Coil, I think a Guavberry, Zygarde. And if I recall correctly, Z-Move, Smackdown, Stealth Rocks, Landorus with Earthquake. And Snow always packing some sort of heat. I'm super hyped to record this game. He's packing Mega Pidgeot, he's packing his own Suicune. His potential rockers are Landorus and Clefable. I'm thinking he's gonna be Z-Move Landorus most likely. Scarf Latios. He leads off with a Pidgeot, has a German nickname, which is funny to me. So this is interesting what Poik will decide to do here. Spikes don't affect anything other than the Suicune. And the same goes for Toxic Spikes, because I assume that the Clefable is gonna be Magic Guard on Snow's team. And yeah, the other Pokemon are all in the air. Latios has Levitate, yeah, there are three flying types. So he's probably gonna, if anything, get up a T-Spike for the Suicune. Because if it's Wincoon, and that doesn't pack grass, so the T-Spike is gonna be important. But yeah, Snow can defog the T-Spike away later. And I assume Snow is just gonna fire off a Hurricane here. And yeah, this match was like highly expected. They're like both really good players. Snow always packing some super wild heat, like he used Mega Camerupt, Mega Obama Snow this World Cup. This time Mega Pidgeot, like you can't really prepare for this guy. I'm not sure yet if he's like a Calmine Clefable or a Stealth Rocks Clefable. That will be interesting to see. There's no timer on, so they're both taking their time here. Yeah, I'm not feeling too well, guys, but I still wanted to bring you the content. AIM used this yesterday in a live with NJMP, if I recall correctly, so... Like, this team is pretty much known. Like, Poik might have changed some things here and there. The more was like SD knockoff. I think Sucker Punch and Play Rough. And there he finally Mega Evolves. There's the Toxic Spike, and I assume the Hurricane is coming out. There's 86, and he gets the Confusion, and... I assume this is like Scarf Lardy from Snowside, like I said, so... Snow might go for U-turn, but I don't know if U-turn would kill a Greninja from 14 if it stays as a poison type. But if Poik goes for a regular spike here, that would get rid of the poison typing, and then U-turn might kill. I assume it's like a Hurricane, Heatwave, U-turn, and then maybe Hidden Power, Ground, or Roost Pidgeot. Oh, they're both pulling a switch. He's pulling. Okay, Poik just stayed in. He pulled a switch out into the Subtle Steeler, and we see this was Mono Gunkshot. He changed it to Surf. So Poik just wanted to get off some damage. He doesn't hit himself in Confusion there. I don't know why I said they're both switched out, because obviously the Greninja is faster. So if Poik switched out too, Greninja would have switched out first. I think after this, there's gonna be Raikou versus Alexander. I'm gonna bring that to you guys too. I assume he's just gonna go for a heavy slam. He goes for a flamethrower, potentially predicting the Morwell to come out. What is Plague gonna do here? I guess he might go for Smackdown, because it would hit the Lari, it would hit the Celesteela. And Snow might just throw up a Leech Seed here. Because if Poik goes for Roxy and Snow goes in the Lari, he can defog both hazards the way that Poik set up. And Poik already took damage on his Greninja. And yeah, that... Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is a Supersonic Sky Strike Lando. So Snow might not want to go Lari and defog because he will get bopped even though he would get a defog off. Poik's Grin is still alive. The thing is, Snow, even if the Grin is still alive, after he defogs, he just has to get his Suicune in before the T-Spikes go up. But the thing is, the Suicune might be forced out at one point, and then if the Lari dies, Poik might be able to set up the T-Spikes again. So we will see how that plays out. Like, he obviously wants to keep his Lari around to defog. Yeah, like, Poik's either gonna smack down or go for rocks here. I don't really see what else he can do. And the tiebreaker between Germany and US East, the games are probably gonna be tomorrow. Like on Wednesday. I'm not sure if I will upload this on Tuesday or Wednesday, but the Germany games should be on Wednesday. Snow might also go out to his own ladders to get an Intimidate off, but Leech Seed seems like a fine play. We shall see what they decide to do. I mean, I understand that Poik is taking his time here because, like, his team's kinda known, like, not kinda, like, people are spamming this on the ladder. Snow probably knows about this team. Black Oblivion used it in World Cup before. So, like, he goes for Smackdown, yeah. And he just goes for Leech Seed, get some health back. So, Poik might go for Roxy, predicting the Protect. I think Snow is gonna go into either his own Landorus or into his... Like, he has like three options here. I don't think he's not going Suicune because he doesn't want to get poisoned, obviously. He wants to defog first. Yeah, he's basically gonna go out to his other mons that are not Suicune, but obviously not Pidgeot because Pidgeot will get bopped by like a Sky Strike. Because Poik might Sky Strike, he predicted him to go into Clefable or Lari. So, yeah, if I would Snow, I would probably go into my own Landorus here to get off the Intimidate. And he also has the Leech Seed to heal back a bit in case Poik goes for like a huge hit like a Sky Strike. And if Poik gets up his rocks, like, Snow doesn't take any damage by going into Landorus. He does just decide to go into his own Landorus. Completely agree with that play, and Snow probably wants to defog later on, like I mentioned a few times now. So he might not set up his own rocks here. This could be a Continental Crush Landorus from Snow. Not sure about the other moves yet. Continental Crush, Earthquake and Rocks is what I'm thinking. Because, like, he doesn't really have other Z-move uses. Unless he's Scarf Landorus and Z-move Lari. But that doesn't make that much sense. Scarf Lari makes a lot more sense for speed control. Scarf Landorus just isn't that fast. Like, you want Scarf Lari to be able to outpace stuff like Volcarona. It also gets potential Trick to help versus the Stall matchup, or like in the Stall matchup in general, even though Poik didn't bring Stall yet this World Cup. But like, Poik can definitely also bring Stall. Like, he doesn't use it often, but you never know, like, he can use a lot of styles. He pivots back into Celesteela on the Greninja. So I think Poik was either predicting the Rocks there, or he was willing to sack his Greninja. Not really sure. Yeah, someone was talking about Axel 10, aka Goat 10 in the chat, so I was checking there if there's another game going on at the same time, but it's not the case. Yes, no, it's free to fire for leech seed here. It's probably goes into Suicune on the flamethrower, looks like a god, does not get burned. So he might have predicted him to go out into the... Yeah, he either predicted the hazards and the Greninja would have died, or he predicted the Mawile, not really sure. But yeah, probably can go for a substitute here, because the Suicune outspeeds the Celesteela for sure. And he doesn't want to get leech seeded. And I guess Snow will go into... He doesn't want to go into his own Kun like I mentioned a few times. Because of the T-Spike, he's either gonna go Lardy or Clef, because Clef has Magic Guard. It just depends on the Clefable set. If the Clef has Calm Mind too, this might be, depending on the Clefable set, Snow might be in a good position. Like, if this Clefable has Calm Mind and 2 attacks, it could potentially beat the Kun 1-on-1. But if it only has Moonblast, Calm Mind, and like T-Wave or Knockoff in the last slot, I think Poeg is in a better position, because Moonblast PP are gonna be, Poeg is gonna be able to stall them out. So Snow might have to defog and then try to like bring in his own Suicune, and like we'll see. This might come down to some Calm Mind wars. So he goes into a Lardy, takes some hazard damage as the Poeg subs up. I'm pretty sure he's just gonna defog because he needs the T-Spikes gone. Like, I don't know how often I'm gonna mention this. Yeah, there's the defog and Poeg is gonna Calm Mind up. Put some pressure on Snow's team, and it just depends on Snow's Clefable set, like I said. So if I'm Poeg, I would just spam Calm Mind here probably, because he could also Scald trying to burn a potential incoming Suicune. But yeah, I think Poeg knows that his Lardy is probably Scarf and locked in the defog, so he has a free turn here to either Calm Mind again or fire off a Scald on Snow's team. If Snow's... I don't know if these Suicunes run max speed. I think they run like some investment in special defense usually. Like 24. But yeah, if like... If Poik's Suicune is slower, or if it's a speed type with Snow's... Okay, he decides they're gonna Clef. And he does get the burn. So if Snow would've gone into Suicune, that would've been really bad for him. Because he most likely doesn't have rest on his Suicune the way it has been played. Because he was like... getting rid of the T-Spike before I brought it out. So if this Clefable has Calm Mind, Snow is in a decent position, but the thing is, Poeg is gonna Calm Mind up to plus 6 here. They're probably both gonna... Like, if Snow also has Calm Mind, he's also gonna Calm Mind up. If Poeg goes to plus 2, and yeah, Snow reveals Calm Mind on his Clef. So this is... we are up for a fun time here. Calm Mind action. The thing is, Poeg's Suicune is fast and he's behind a substitute. So if he's at plus 6 and he gets a crit, Snow's Clefable basically dies. And the thing is, Poeg is gonna be able to spam Scald a few times because, like I said, he has a sub up, he's faster, so he's more on the offensive. But if he does not get the crit, he will eventually run out of Scalds. And also if he's low on Scalds, Snow Suicune can Calm Mind up and potentially reverse sweep Poeg. Especially if, like I said, I was talking earlier, I don't know if I finished that sentence. If Snow Suicune can win a speed die and like get a substitute up before Poeg's, he can basically PP stall Poeg out because of the pressure ability. Because he can sub down and protect. And Scald only has 24 PP with pressure, that means it only has 12 PP. He will also lose some Scald PP versus this Clefable already, probably. Yeah, like, I'm pretty sure they're just both gonna click Calm Mind. Like, we obviously know that Snow's Clef is gonna be packing Calm Mind, Softball, and Moonblast. It just comes down to the last move. Options in my head are either Knockoff, Stored Power, or Thunder Wave. If it's Stored Power and he plays it well, he actually has a decent chance. Yeah, so they're both gonna go to plus 6 and then they're gonna start attacking. And I think Moonblast is not able to break the substitute. So Poeg's Suicune should easily be able to stall that out. So it just comes down to what Snow's last move is, and if Poeg can get a crit. If Poeg can get a crit, this game might just be over or highly in his favor. But overall, if Snow doesn't get crit, this game is hard. Like, he should win this game if he doesn't get crit. But a crit chance is like 6.6 to 5%. So now he's firing off attacks, that does 27. Snow's at plus 6, so the next one is gonna do even less. So you guys can see, if he doesn't get a crit, he protects separately in the Moonblast. So he has, Moonblast has 24 PP, right? So he has 22 left. Basically only has 12 PP as he's fishing for the crit. It only has 12 PP because of the pressure ability from Suicune. You can see Snow is probably gonna softball here. And he was spamming Calm Mind, not wanting to waste Moonblast. So like, kinda trying to stall out Puig of Scald. Because if Puig runs out of Scald, Snow's own Suicune like might beat Puig's Suicune one-on-one. But yeah, interesting comment. But like, if just Puig just gets one crit, it's gonna be really scary for Snow. Because then he's forced out into his own Suicune, that's like the only thing he has. And then he has to hope that he's like faster and can sub up and like stall him out of Scalds, like I said earlier. Still fishing for the crit, does not get it. I think that was like the 4th or 5th Scald already. So he has like 18 more or something like that. Yeah, Snow did not reveal his last move yet. Someone was talking about that in the Smoktus chat. Was asking it. There's the substitute that does not break. There's the Moonblast is what I meant to say. And now Puig is also clicking Calm Mind, not wanting to waste more. Not wanting to waste all his Scalds, but the thing is eventually he has to attack again. And I feel like this is a tough spot for Puig if he doesn't get the crit. I already talked about this. Like, Snow is getting his leftovers back, but a crit should still be able to Oko the Clef, because I think the Clef is more fifth dev orientated. And a plus 6 crit, like, it obviously ignores the Clefable speed dev boost, so but if it doesn't Oko, it will do like 90, but I think it should Oko. Both just spamming Calm Mind. Look at Nelson in the chat saying, reveal stored power, please. We shall see if he has that. As he does break the sub with another Moonblast. Puig is just gonna sub down again here. Like, I don't know yet if Snow's plan might just be to get rid of the Scald PP from Puig. Or he might have some tricks on his sleeve. We will see his last move slot. He will reveal it eventually. It's just a bit sad that this match might come down to like, this kinda comes down to PP stall or whoever crits first. The thing is, Puig is like the only one who can crit, because Snow can't really crit at the moment, because the substitute, like even if he crits the substitute, he does reveal stored power that does break the substitute. Stored power only has 16 PP though, so it only has 8 versus Suicune, the wasted one, so he has 7 more. So Puig has to predict this, play this correct eventually. Like, he has to predict a turn where, like, if Snow predicts him to go for Protect to waste a Moonblast, which is the case now. So now Puig didn't go for Sub. If he subbed that, it would have been a good play on Puig's part. So I hover over here to check the PP. He has like 8 Moonblasts left. I think 7 stored powers. With pressure calked in. But yeah, if Puig substitutes on a turn, like, now this turn substitute is pretty obvious and he's probably just gonna go for Substitute. But if Puig subs on a turn with Snow thinks he's gonna protect, Snow might go for Moonblast or not attack. And Puig might be able to get up a sub, which will be really helpful in stalling out stored power PP. If he does sub again, he does stored power, just break the sub to get... I mean, he already used 2 PP of stored power, which means he used 4 thanks to pressure. So I think he only has 6 left versus the Coon. So now it would be a really good play for Puig to sub again, because Snow is not gonna store power here because the Protect is so obvious. And the Protect is not gonna break, the Substitute is not gonna break to a Moonblast as we saw earlier unless he gets a crit. So if I'm Puig, I would sub here. But yeah, Snow really had the tech. I don't know if this was specifically, as yeah, we see he has 16 Scalds left. As he does sub break the Moonblast, be a nice play. I don't know if, so he only has 7 Moonblasts left. I don't know if he specifically brought the stored power, Calm Mind, Moonblast, Clefable. He Calm Mind's separating the Protect, not wanting to waste the Moonblast. Really nice play on his part. So if another Moonblast breaks, the sub is gonna go for it, but there's the crit for Puig and the Clefable goes down. And now this game might just be over. Porg is in a really good position all of a sudden. I mean, the thing is, Snow was kind of on the defensive, right? Because he's slower. But the thing is also... Okay, I have to stop saying the thing is... In the long run, Snow would have won this. He just had to avoid a few more crits. He does show Protect. Porg does go for Scald. I think Porg has like... had like 15 scores left, so now he should be at 13 thanks to pressure. He does sub, so Snow is eventually faster, or you want to speed tier there, which means Porg's gold is gonna be super low now. So Snow can just protect here, we hover over, he only has 11 scores left. We will see if Snow Suicune is faster again after this protect on the next turn. Pretty sure Porg will go for Command here, predicting a protect, not wanting to waste another scald. He does sub again, predicting him to not scald, but he does scald in the sub breaks. So Snow Suicune seems to be faster, so he's probably running like max speed. Or he's like speed creeping the standard Vincune, I'm not sure. But yeah, Porg is eventually gonna be forced out. Cause he has like no scald PP left, and with protect and sub in combination, Snow is gonna be able to stall out all Porg's scald PP. So even though Porg got that lucky crit that brought him in a good position, Snow is not out of this game yet. I think he's gonna protect here, right? Cause if he keeps subbing, he's gonna be kinda low. Yeah, Kun, they're talking about it in the Smogdus chat. Kun wasn't recovering back to full and versus the Clef. That is kinda lucky for Poik. Like, yeah, he had sub and protect, but he was still losing health versus the Clef, and eventually his Kun would have gone down. And even if he got the crit a bit later, he would have wasted more Scald PP. But the thing is, yeah, that he's also really low. He's already really low in Scald. That crit definitely sucked for Snow. We shall see if he can bring it back. He keeps subbing down, predicting Poik to not Scald. He only has 7 Scalds left, which means probably 4 Scald versus the Kun thanks to pressure. But yeah, Snow's gonna be forced to protect eventually. But he's definitely faster with his Kun because he subbed down like 3 times and he was always faster. He does switch out in 9, he's predicting protect. And he gets this play correct. Amazing tactical maneuvers. Poik never misplays, as someone would say. I know Poik got lucky, but still, in general, Poik just... You see him misplay like super rarely, if that is correct English. I hope that is correct English. So he's gonna be able to set up his Aurora Veil here, or fire off Hypnosis. The Snow might just go out into his Celesteela. Like, these 9 tests, they carry Freeze Dry, so he's not gonna stay in with his Kun here. As there's the Aurora Veil. And these 9 does pack Light Clay, so he has 8 turns of screens. Aurora Veil is really cool because it gives you both screens. It gives you Reflect and Light Screen, like one move, it's pretty nice. It's like funny because it's a hail team, but you only have one that sets hail and you have like no hail abusers. Like, these teams never really use Pokemon like alone, Sandslash or something like that with like the Snow Cloak or have a... Oh, no, not Snow Cloak. There's like Slush Rush, this new ability which doubles the speed and hail. They don't really use that. They just use the screens. They just abuse the screens and Hypnosis from Ninetales, and then you have like a lot of setup Pokemon in the back. They really appreciate the screens to get free setup. And then the Figgy Baggy on Zagat. I think NGMP said Zagat is like S plus rank behind screens because you can set up coils and DDs. And you have like Zagat doesn't die to everything behind screens. Like, HPIs from Landers does pitiful damage behind screens to like Zygarde. The Zygarde also has some HP investment. And even if you get the Zygarde down, it has like the berry that hits at 50%. So yeah, Poik might go for Hypnosis here. And Snow's either gonna go for Leech Seed or potential Flamethrower. Cause if the Morwell is intimidated, Morwell could come in easily on a heavy slam, so I think he would probably go for a Flamethrower over Heavy Slam. I don't think Poik would go in a Zygarde here on a potential Leech Seed. Yeah, he's probably gonna try to put this to sleep or something. This is intense, man. Already 25 minutes in. And yeah, this is... the Italian people are gonna be, Italian players are gonna be, our community is gonna be pretty annoyed by this hex. I kinda know both players, so it's tough for me. Who am I rooting for? Like, Snow is on my Discord, I know Poik just a little bit, I know Snow a bit more, but Poik, I just like... Like, he's definitely, they're both upcoming players, like, I don't know, like, it's not like they're new players, like, Poik is more a little bit new, I think Snow was also in the last World Cup. I haven't really been following World Cup in the last year, so I'm not sure how many World Cups Snow has been in, but they both were in SPL. I feel like they're just both really good, and, like, Snow... Like I said earlier, you can't really prep for him, he always has some Heat Mega or some Heat sort of team. So he does go on a Morwald. So he did not go for Hypnosis, he just sacked his Greninja off. Which means there's not gonna be T-Spikes in this game. But yeah, Snow Suicune is already at like below half, so he's gonna SD up on the Leech Seed. And he's probably just gonna knock off. So if Snow... I think knockoff might kill the Celesteela because it's spit death and it's still a Mega Morwile. And if you knock off an item, it does a lot of damage. So the only Pokemon that can switch in on this is probably the Landris. I think everything else would get OKO'd by knockoff. Pretty sure Mega Pidgeot might even get OKO'd. But yeah, I don't really know the calc for that. I mean, if Poik predicts a switch and knockoff doesn't OKO the Pidgeot or the Landers, I'm pretty sure it doesn't OKO the Landers because that should be Z-move. He can go for Play Rough, but overall, knockoff is just a safe play for Poik, I feel. Like, he doesn't really have to risk anything, he's gonna get a huge hit off here. And you can see, oh, he does Protect, so he does just get some Leech Seed, and Poik does knockoff. So Snow got that play correct, wow, like, if Poik SD'd again, that would've been scary. Because then he would've guaranteed gotten a kill. But now, it's still kinda the scenario where Snow can potentially go Landris predicting knockoff, and if he's Z-move he can live that. And then he has the Leech Seed on the Morwald to heal him back a little bit. There's like 4 turns left of Aurora Veil. Celesteela, keeping his Celesteela healthy is nice because he can Leech Seed the Zygarde later on. If he does go hard into Landris, predicting knockoff, does eat it up, so we do see it's Z-move Landris. So Earthquake probably doesn't even kill the Morwile because of the Aurora Veil. So Poik might just go for a knockoff again here. He might also go for Sucker Punch, not wanting to take any damage on his Morwile. So Snow might just play some mind games. He might just go for like, if he predicts a Sucker Punch, he can go for like SD or Rocks. And then he would, Poik would lose more Leech Seed recovery. So I don't know if Poik thinks this Morwile is still valuable and wants to switch out and save it for later. Or if he's just gonna go for the attack here. Because if he takes the Earthquake to the face, he's probably gonna be super low. I assume it's gonna do like, maybe half to the Morwile, maybe. I'm not sure if it's gonna kill. Landris is a really high attack stat. If this Morwile has no HP investment, Earthquake might be a roll to kill. So he does switch out into his own Landris. Snow goes for the Rex Rocks, makes a ballsy play there, ballsy play. Potentially predicting a Sucker Punch. So maybe Earthquake was a roll to kill, I'm not sure. But yeah, Snow's actually back in this game. Like, it's 5 versus 5, he got his Rocks up. And the screen, the Aurora Veil is gonna run out too soon. So I think Poik is gonna get up his own Rocks here. Snow throws up and gets up an SD, and now Snow gets a kill. Like, Poik has to sack something here, and then he can set up the Aurora Veil again. So Snow might get 2 kills, as he does... I think this is a speed tie, right? No, Snow's Lander was faster tries, maybe Poik's Landris Adamant? I thought they were both Jolly, I'm not sure. But he goes for Continental Crush, picks up the Landris, not wanting to risk a Stone Age miss. He just got a free kill there pretty much with Continental Crush. So Poik is gonna set up the Aurora Veil again here. If Earthquake doesn't kill, Snow might have to hit a Stone Age here to kill the Ninetales. Because Freeze Dry obviously kills the Landris. He might just go for Freeze Dry at first, because the Landris is a threat. Yeah, that Delano is a threat, so Poet might just go for freeze dry. So if Snow predicts freeze dry, he can just go Celeste Dealer. Because a bulky Celeste Dealer probably takes like 10% from freeze dry. I think this 9th is max HP, max speed. It doesn't really, it doesn't have special attack investment. 9th is also kind of weak. So this Landorus is nice for Snow in the sense that he can get an Intimidate later on the Mawile and on the Zygarde. So he might just go Celeste Dealer breaking the freeze dry. He does just do that. Poik goes for the Aurora Veil though, and yeah, I don't think Poik lost much from that. So he was willing to sack his 9th in case Snow stayed in. So Poik can either try to hit Hypnosis here or he can switch out. But he's probably just gonna sack off the 9th. Like if he hits the Hypnosis, it's fine for him and he can switch out after and hope that Snow doesn't get a first turn work. But if he misses Hypnosis, he's probably gonna get bopped by a heavy slam. He might also go for Leech Seed here, because Pokemon like Zygarde don't take much damage from Heavy Slam. He does hit an Hypnosis. His 9th is well trained, so like you gotta be I gotta adjust. Like Poke has been like somewhat lucky, or like really lucky this game so far. He got the crit and he has been hitting his Hypnosis. But yeah, his 9th is well trained. And yeah, like ICT's talking about it in the chat. This being asleep, Landorus being and Kuhn being weakened already, Pidgeot not gonna be able to do much damage to Zygarde behind screen, so Zygarde might just wrap this up for Poik late game. If he goes on the Mawile, there's no first turn wake for Snow. I mean, the first guaranteed turn, he was asleep, he already burnt that, was the 9th, and he did not get the first turn wake on the switch. So Poik might just go for an attack here, because if he goes for SD and Celeste Dealer wakes up, he's probably gonna die to a flamethrower. And if he knocks off the leftovers on the Celeste Dealer, it's gonna be really nice for Poik. Ward the Celeste Dealer down. Bring it in range from Zygarde, potentially. I mean, he's gonna have to Dragon Dance with Zygarde anyway. The Latias is Scarf, so I think Zygarde needs like 3 Dragon Dances to it. I don't know if Zygarde outspeeds Latias after 2 DDs. If the Zygarde doesn't run max speed, it should outspeed the Pidgeot after 1 DD. Does it? Oh yeah, the Zygarde runs like Adamant with like 76 HP investment if it's the same team. I'm not 100% sure, but I think it should outspeed the Pidgeot after Dragon Dance. Yeah. Not 100% sure, he does go for knockoff, get rid of the lefties, and he does get a 3 turn sleep. Snow does not wake up. So yeah, this is a lot that's going in Poik's way this game. So not sure if the next knockoff is gonna kill, because the last did 49. So without an item, I think this knockoff only does less. Oh my lord, he gets another crit. So if Snow woke up there, like, I think Snow had like a really high chance to wake up there and flamethrower would have killed the Mawile. And what Poik would have done afterwards is probably go into the Zygarde or into the Suicune. I think he would have gone Zygarde. I'm not sure if this crit played a huge role. So Snow might have to like intimidate the Zygarde later on in the game, and like potentially if Suicune can live a hit, he might have to Scald Burn the Zygarde, or he might have to go for Draco crit through the Aurora Veil or like Hurricane Confusion. We shall see. But yeah, unfortunate events so far. Snow not having the greatest luck so far. I think he's gonna go out into his Landorus here. Or Pidgeot can click Heat Wave. I'm not sure if that kills behind Aurora Veil, but I'm kind of thinking this Mawile is like super offensive. Like maybe it doesn't have a lot of HP investment, so Heat Wave might just kill, because like Mawile doesn't have the best speed def, even though it gets like more bulk after Mega Evolving. He does hit the Heat Wave. Oh yeah, it has the ability that it connects every move. What's the ability called again? Like it always hits Hurricane, it's called No Guard, it always hits Hurricane and Heatwave. So it does pick off the Mawile, and Poik has 2 turns left, and he's gonna Dragon Dance up here. The Zygarde should win the game for Poik now. unless Snow gets a Hurricane Confusion or Drake or Chris. Because Zygarde, my man Dennis in the chat, some justice please. Aladi obviously still outspeeds Zygarde, but I'm pretty sure Draco doesn't kill through the screens, even in the combination with a Hurricane. And I think the combination of Hurricane and Draco, like, I'm not sure how much Draco is gonna do to this. It might bring the Zygarde in the range from the Figgy Berry or however the berry is called that heals it back. But your Poik is probably gonna Dragon Dance up here. I think that enables him to outspeed the Landorus, the Suicune, if he wasn't able to outspeed them before that. It should also make him faster than Pidgeot, so the only one that it doesn't outspeed is the Latias after DD, I think. He does U-turn out, so he did not go for the Hurricane Confusion. So he either has to go Suicune here and hope that he can live a hit on like a low roll. But I think his Suicune is probably dead to a plus 1 T arrows. Or he's gonna go Landorus to intimidate this. If he goes Lati, he has to hope for a crit, so I don't know if that's the play. But Snow's just put in a tough spot here because of all the hacks against him. And even though, like, I think they've both been playing well. But if there was no hacks on both, what do I mean on both sides? I think the only hacks that was happened so far was in Poik's favor, right? But I'm not gonna take anything away from Poik. I still think he played well so far. As he does go for Dragon Dance, and Snow's gonna go for the crit here, probably with a Draco Meteor. He does miss. Oh my lord! Yeah, this game is over. He does pick up the kill. The Draco might have barely not put the Zygarde in the Figgy Berry range, so it might have. He might have been able to revenge this with after the Intimidate. And like, now the screens ended, so with the Intimidate that he got off, he might have been able to revenge it with a Hurricane from Pidgeot. Not sure. Yeah, Pidgeot should be able to live an E-Speed from half, right? Because it's not banded. It's like a Dragon Dance Zygarde and it's neutral. But Thousand Arrows probably just picks up the kill for Poik. Poik can also Dragon Dance again here, as long as he doesn't get Earthquake critted. Oh yeah, they're asking in the chat if crit ignores Veil. Yeah, like, obviously, like, Veil is like Light Screen and Reflect. Crit obviously goes through that. And yeah, someone said couldn't pull DD again and Blunder confirms it, like I was thinking. At plus 2 it's still slower than Scarf Lari. Yeah, plus 2 E-Speed might kill the Lati, but then there might be the option that Snow goes back into Landorus on the E-Speed, and then plus 1 E-Speed probably might not kill the Lati. And then the Aurora Velva is gone, so I completely agree with Poik's play, just clicking T-Arrows, killing the Lati, as long as he had the Veil up. As he goes on a Suicune, so this is gonna get 2-hit KO'd, or maybe just... He does coil, yeah, this game is over. Yeah, I don't know why I said DD again, because he already outspeeds his entire team, so coil was the correct play to take less damage from Earthquake. Let's pick off the Suicune, and yeah, he gets another Intimidate, but this game is over, like... Snow far hard, but it was not enough at the end, the Hex just was too much. Okay, someone posted the Kulk. Draco Meteor would have done 41 to 48 in the Aurora Veil, which is absolutely nothing. Oh my lord. But yeah, the Clefable would have been able to probably beat down the Suicune. And then Snow's own Suicune would have been more healthy. It would have been just a different game. I'm not sure if he would have 100% won, but he would have had like a really good shot at winning. As someone said, they should nerf it to make it gone when a hill is down, the Aurora Veil. Someone said, then you would just use the Icy Rock. As yeah, there's the kill, and probably just gonna, yeah, pick up the kill here. Thank you guys for watching. Poik picks up the win for Team Spain. I know a lot of people or players from Team Italy are gonna be super mad. Also, my man Dennis. I saw him talk a bit in Italian in the Smogtooth chat. So that the score is 1-0 for Team Spain versus Italy. There's three games in this tiebreaker, so if Italy wins the next game, we're gonna go to a third game. I think the next game is gonna be Reiko versus Alexander. They're gonna play Oras OU, and if Reiko picks up the win, oh my lord, he didn't even say GG back, but I can understand it because he got hexed. But yeah, if Reiko picks up the win versus Alexander, it's gonna be 2-0, and Spain is gonna move on to the next round, which is semifinals, aka round 3. And if Dennis in the chat, that wasn't a GG though. If Alex can pick up the win versus Reiko, we're gonna see a game 3 between Brokepa and Raikou, which will be deciding. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you later with the next game for Oras OU World Cup tiebreaker. And also the Germany vs US East games are gonna be coming to you. Stay tuned for that. Have a nice day. Dockridge signing out, and congrats to Poik, and yeah, unfortunate event. Unfortunate hex. Snow got hexed, and yeah. See you later. Goodbye.